You're not gonna look at me and tell me that the film industry isn't dying. I'm just saying, look. If you look at the simple facts, we're losing the art of film. We really truly are. We really truly are. There's a big difference between entertainment and art, and we're trying to merge them at the seams, and they just don't work together. They don't work together. You can't put out a Marvel film, and yes, it's a cinematic universe and it's cinema and everything. However, there's a difference between art and entertainment. There can be We, especially this Generation Z, we've got to completely erase the idea that everything is art. You can't say everything is art. You can say everything has a beauty to it, everything has a magnificence to it. However, calling everything art waters down the true meaning of what the word art and artistry means. There's a beauty and a magnificence to a lot of things, but I wouldn't call it art. And you look at the entertainment... You look at the film industry now, and you can clearly see there's a loss. I mean, look, the beginning of this year, a wonderful, beautiful film, Malcolm and Marie, came out, and people lost it. They hit, and that's fine. Malcolm and Marie is not for everyone. However, Malcolm and Marie is a cinematic masterwork. You will understand the reference if you watch it. It's a cinematic masterwork because it dives into the hard, gritty, gruesome ideas of what it truly means to be in a relationship, a toxic relationship, and to be in a relationship about black love, and to be in a relationship where you are experiencing the true, raw emotions of being an actress and being a filmmaker woven into the story. Two characters. That's it. That's all you need. That's all you need to tell an amazing story. And that's what Sam Levinson did in that film. That's what John David Washington did. And that's what Zendaya did. It's so amazing.
I feel like once you know someone is there for you, and once you know they love you, you never actually think of them again.
That's not true.
It's until you're about to lose someone that you finally pay attention.
Is that what this is?
What?
It's what you're threatening. If I don't apologize, I'm going to lose you?
I'm not looking for an apology, Malcolm.
Well, what do you want, a screenplay credit?
Don't be cruel.
No, I'm serious. I know we talk for hours and hours about work. Is it so much of a fucking nuisance that you'd like compensation? I had a draft of this script before you ever came into my life.
That is the true art of film and cinema. Even, I agree with her. Even Zendaya said it felt like they were putting on a play, and that's what it is. We are losing the beauty of theater and cinema, and theater within ourselves. If you look at some of the things you do every day, you would be shocked and surprised at how beautiful and theatrical they are. And we lose that because everything on cinema has become so small. It's become, put your voice in a lower tone and say something very deep. Like this. I don't know, I just fought. I fought so hard for everything I wanted. And in the end, I didn't get any of it. Any of it at all. And then you have to come back from... And that's the issue, is there's a beautiful art to acting in film. There's a beautiful art to acting in theater. I'm studying the theater. I love it. It's so amazing. The issue is with film nowadays, you can clearly see the audience, and TV, you can clearly see the audiences they're trying to target. And it's a money-making industry. Yes, you want to make money. That's why you do it. You want to make money. You should be trying to change the world with your films. I look at someone like Mahershala Ali. Oh my God, Mahershala Ali. He is the king. You look at his acting ability, you look at the way that he fully dives into the given circumstances of a character. He is a brilliant, beautiful actor, a brilliant, beautiful human who can step into those given circumstances and fully give it everything he's got. The issue is, there's so much watered down acting in cinema, there's so much watered down cinematography, so much watered down writing. Why has the writing become so meaningless now? Why do some writers do this? It may be a technique, I don't know. However,
if character A and character B just had a really bad breakup, no matter who they are, character A, character B had a really bad breakup. However, character A broke up with character B because character C made character A cheat. Let's just say that. Let's just say that. Let's say character C dragged character A on top of them when they were on a bed and character B walked in. When character A goes to talk to character B about character A and C's interaction, they'll start to say something like, everything is not what it seems. And before they can even get a single next word out of their mouth, character B's like, no, I'm done. I'm breaking up with you. Look, character A, you could have just said they dragged me on top of them. And I understand you have to progress a story. You have to get to a certain place that you want to get to. However, stop watering down the dialogue. The best thing about Malcolm and Marie, one of the best things is the dialogue, is the beautiful theatrical words they use to express their feeling and emotion and action and want, and super objective to each other. They don't water down the dialogue to try and meet some sort of margin of a time limit you have to get an episode. They truly use those words and they use those phrases and they do something with it. They make them matter.
A fucking movie. A tragedy, one that you can continue watching for as long as you were there for me. And tonight, in that fucking audience, I watched the whole shit play out, so don't pretend like it was a selfless fucking act, Malcolm.
I mean, why did Pontecorvo, a fucking rich Italian Jewish man, why did he fucking feel such a kinship to Algerian Muslim guerrilla fighters that he fucking made Battle of Algiers? A fucking classic.
And in cinema today, there's a lot of fake representation. A lot of fake representation because, yes, I understand. You do have to satisfy your white audiences. Only 40% of the population in America is African American, and it's probably less and less for people who are Asian American, people who are Hispanic, Latino, or Latinx, etc. They have to satisfy those audiences in the Mideast, the Midwest, in states that are more southern, like South Carolina. They have to satisfy them because that's where their money comes from. And then overseas, when they're trying to get a film that satisfies a lot of audiences, the more diverse films, the films that don't necessarily have some white people in it, do not sell as well overseas. And that's why some of these films are just all white, because for some reason we've been taught that white people are the default. Well, you're not. you're not. Another big thing is a lack of fresh ideas in film. And it's okay to fall into tropes and fall into archetypes in film and in TV because you can work your way around them. However, especially when it's 60-year-old white men trying to write for a 15-year-old person who's in Generation Z, it's not going to work. It's not going to work. It's going to fail every time because you don't truly understand the experience. Like I said before, it's so watered down. So watered down. Everything is not what it seems. It's truly a shame. We've lost the art of film, because film is so many things. Film is from the sound design to the cinematographer to the director and the actors, all of it. However, when I look at some films nowadays and I'm truly trying to dive into them and I'm truly trying to find the deeper meaning in some of them don't have anything. And we're going on the spectrum of more entertainment, less trying to change the world, less trying to tell a story that actually truly matters, less trying to dive into these things that human beings are actually struggling with, because we're so concerned with making money and with driving in audiences. Why did Moonlight win Best Picture at the Oscars? You know why. And yes, there are so many different ways. Film is an art. Cinematography is an art. There are so many different ways to interpret it and to do it. However, when it comes to moments like these in the world where we're sort of just now exiting this new freaking these variants coming out, where we're trying to exit out of this pandemic, just get vaccinated. We're trying to exit out of this pandemic, and we're trying to fight out of it. And there are going to be films that have to meet this moment. TV shows that are gonna have to meet the moment. We can no longer live in this fake reality that this isn't happening right now. You know, we look at films like Malcolm Marie and Moonlight, and we think about them on such a deeper, broader level because they truly say something about our society that cuts deep. The movies that you have no words to express after all of that was just thrown at you, those are some of the most beautiful films. The things that we're wrestling with internally, deeply within ourselves, that they perfectly captured on a screen. Films like The Shape of Water, my God. You know? Those Oscar-nominated films, you know? And they don't all have to be white. I'm trying to dive more into black filmmaking, trying to dive a whole lot more into it. Because I want to appreciate people who express my experience in this country. I mean, look at a film like Two Distant Strangers on Netflix. That. We can no longer wait for other people to tell our stories for us, no matter what that story may be. We have to tell our story. Just look at all the many aspects of the film industry, from the way Hollywood works, to who gets casted, to weight and age and gender and sexuality, to the way we film, to the big budget motion pictures, to the small independent films. I would rather choose a $5,000 scrappy made, dingy behind film that some random filmmaker out of Columbus, Ohio made than a $500 million motion picture. Why? Because those $5,000 films actually have heart. They have heart. They have something to say. They had to scrap and claw for everything they wanted to say. Those $500 million films, you can have it. You can have it. You got the money. You got the resources. Are you saying anything? Are you talking about anything that actually matters? Rather than what the majority white audience would understand, oh my God, yeah. When you encapsulate the human soul and a spirit inside of an hour to 4 hour long film, no matter how long it is, you do something to someone. Love, death, and sex are the three most fundamental things that Shakespeare wrote about. They are the three fundamental things that every human being on planet Earth, it's the three things that really can make us human. It's the three universal ideas that surround us all the time. Love, death, and sex. Start there, filmmakers. Like, start. I'm a young filmmaker myself. I love film. I love theater. I love art. And it's a shame when I see it being ruined by people who have to satisfy certain audiences, have to satisfy a certain demographic, have to satisfy certain streaming services or overseas services or overseas audiences. It's a true shame. There are films that you look at and you look at interviews and the filmmaker can break down why every single shot was exactly where it was supposed to be. And there are some interviews you look at where they can't even answer why the film was titled what the film was titled. So there's a disconnect happening here. We make movies, as Viola Davis said, she's thankful that she became an artist because we are the only profession that celebrates what it means to live a life. I became an artist, and thank God I did, because it is the only profession that celebrates what it means to live a life. And when that life is snatched from film, what is film? It's just B-roll footage. It's just stock footage. Just because hard work goes into something doesn't classify it as art. Just because hard work went into something does not classify that something as art. And if we lose the life and the essence of film, if we lose the true art of it, if we lose the essence and the message, then other people will underestimate the power of film's presence, and they should never do that. Because film's presence is a present. Thank you.